So does a people's diplomacy really work, and would it work with Iran? These questions come as the former U.S. envoy to the United Nations says Israel has until August 21st to attack Iran's nuclear sites. This before Russia finalizes its shipment of nuclear fuel to Iran. Joining me for more on the story is investigative journalist and RT contributor Wayne Madsen. Hey there, Wayne. Now, the Iranian people are aware of Israel's attack. And, you know, we just had a report showing that before the war in Iraq, there were human shields, there were a lot of people who tried to prevent that war, this, you know, people's diplomacy. And we have that now with Iran, a lot of American civilians going over there to engage in this kind of diplomacy. Is it going to work in preventing war with Iran?
Oh, absolutely not. If the Israelis decide to attack Iran, it doesn't matter whether civilian volunteers over there, the New York Yankees happen to be in Tehran. None of that's going to matter. They're going to hit Iran, and people like John Bolton, he's one of these old neocon types. They're the ones who lied about intelligence to get us into the Iraq War, and they continue to hype up intelligence, cook it. They provide false information, and Bolton is keying everything to this August 21st date. The Bushehr reactor is a peaceful power reactor. It has nothing to do with weapons production.
Now, I want to ask you something else, because Bolton says that they need to attack Iran. They need to attack Iran by August 21st, because if they do so afterwards, it's going to endanger Iranian civilians. Radiation's going to go out and everything else. But is the worry here that if the Russians do transfer this before August 21st, it would bring Russia into the equation of attacking Iran?
Well, the Russian technicians and engineers are already in Bushehr, so whether it happens before August 21st, on that day, or after, there could be Russian casualties. And yes, it would bring Russia into the equation. And as far as radiation, of course, we hear that Israel may be targeting other Iranian nuclear facilities in Natanz and in Qom and in Tehran itself. So the fact is that radiation would be a big problem with monsoon rains coming from the Central Asian steppes, swinging south, picking up radiation, and possibly dumping this radioactive rain on three other nuclear powers, Pakistan, India, and China. This could get out of hand very, very rapidly.
Now, I want to bring the U.S. into the equation. Just not too long ago, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Michael Mullen, said that there's a contingency plan to strike Iran. And in response to that, the Iranians built mass graves for American soldiers. Talk to me about the preparations for war on both sides, or actually from the Israeli perspective, the American and the Iranian perspective.
Well, the Iranians, of course, that would be a nice, you know, propaganda thing. Remember, Saddam said, it'll be the mother of all battles. So you get a lot of that kind of rhetoric when you've got this brinksmanship going on. But obviously, Iran's plans to retaliate would be against the Saudi oil refineries. They would see Saudi complicity in any Israeli attack, because the Saudi airspace would obviously be used by Israeli aircraft on their way to hit Iran. Depending on how the U.S. reacts, they may just turn on their cells in Iraq, the Shias, who are very much involved with the Iraqi government of Maliki, and U.S. troops there could be targeted, as well as U.S. Navy ships in the Gulf. So now Israel's preparations, I would say, we know that Israel's in range for some Iranian missiles. Depending on how good their air defenses are, they could be hit. But I think Hezbollah would also react from Lebanon, and we would see a wave of rocket attacks on Israel from Hezbollah. Possibly, if there's any left in Gaza, Hamas might join in. So we may see Israeli retaliation against Lebanon and Gaza.
It could unravel mass destruction worldwide, then, it seems. That's Wayne Madsen, RT contributor and investigative journalist.